All right, here we go, here we go. Some big old Bowie knives. All right, and choppers. Bowie knives and choppers. Kukris, long blades. Like this one here. This is the Camillus Carnivore X with the newly done handle. Well, it ain't new anymore, but this ain't the original one they came out with. This is the up. This is the redone over with the full, the true full tang. They extend throughout the palm, through the back of the palm. Okay. So we're gonna take a look at some of these big blades. Some of my favorite ones here. Some of my favorite big blades. Here. Starting with the Timber Rattler TR65 Western Outlaw Bowie. The one I did that. Did my own little grip shape on. Make it for a nice big hand. Feels good. Feels good and comfortable. Then we got the Mossy Oak Wood Handle Bowie. Very thin. I need to do this handle like that. But this is a nice cutting knife. Very powerful. Very powerful. Might be made in China, but for a cheap knife, it performs very well. And I'd say same thing for this Mossy Oak encapsulated full tang knife. Imitation of the Marine Raider Bowie, if you ask me. But nevertheless, it's a first knife. Got a nice size lanyard holding there. Look like it's lined with aluminum. Tough plastic here. Probably a special type of plastic. Then we got the same plastic down at the bottom of the end of the handle. And then we got a more spongy rubber in the middle with some palm swell there. Feels good in the hand. Then we got a Kukri. This is a small Kukri. They sold it as a 9-inch, but this is shorter than a 9-inch Kukri. Was traditionally sold as a 9-inch Kukri. Okay. So, but nevertheless, it's got that, called buffalo bone handle, buffalo horn handle with the rat tail type tang. It's not a rat tail like they put on the knives. It's like a tapered thin down tang to keep the weight forward and in the balance. Give it less weight in the back, more for chopping. And this is a really good cutter. This thing cuts like I don't know what, but yeah, it's still a big blade. And we got this one. This is also buffalo horn. Both of these, this one and this one in my hand here, are ex-Gurkha Kukri knives. You know, I read a comment a man wrote. He said he keep his ex-Gurkha Kukri knife on the floor. It's in two pieces to remind him not to buy another one. I thought it was kind of funny, you know. But he knows about blades, so you know you can't really argue with him. He said that, you know, he just doesn't, he don't really care for these, obviously. But yeah, I haven't had any problem with mine so far. But yeah, this is the ex-Gurkha Kukri service number one with the buffalo horn handle. Then we have the knockoff, I call it. It's a beautiful knife, though. Of the, if you look at it, you'll figure out what it looks like. Looks like a Western 49er. But it's the Turtle Man boy. Yeah, I believe the old Turtle Man is using a Western 49er as his original knife. Very wise of him. Because that's a tough blade. Yeah, and when he out there, he wants something he can rely on. He can show enough rely on a Western 49er. So yeah, this is a copy of that. This is the Turtle Man boy. Nice wood type looking handle. It's wood, but what type of wood, I don't know. It's probably manufactured wood. But nevertheless, it looks good and it feels good. And it's got the same manufactured wood, more or less, they call it. But it's got the same blade and hander designer is the Western 49er. I like that. Okay, and then we got a charade. I like this Arkansas toothpick style Bowie knife. You know, this is a little small sword, if you ask me. Short sword. It's like a dagger. Short sword. It's just a first knife. It's a work knife, but actually, if you really get down to it, it can be used for a lot of things. It can be used for kitchen work, you know, cutting food. It can be used for camp, around the camp, if you're into the camp scene. And it can also be used as a knife to defend yourself. Now, we come to one of my favorites. One that I put a little paracord wrap on the handle there. Yep, did that handle pretty well. This is the 151 MTAC with the USA design. Everybody call it the knockoff. What is it? Trailmaster. Yeah, they call it the ripoff or knockoff Trailmaster, which I think is a good knife. They say it's a USA design knife, so they designed it after the Trailmaster. But they call it the 151 MTAC. Here's another one. You could say this is a copy of the Case Double X Boy. But they call this the Marine Raider. The Raider Boy. The USMC Raider Boy. Bowie. You know, whichever one you like to prefer. Sometimes I say them interchangeably. But Bowie is what I generally say. Okay, so this boy is a first chopper too. It's made of stainless steel. As this is made of stainless steel, and this, and so is this. These two are carbon steel. This is stainless steel. This is a mystery steel, but it's a good steel, and this is a stainless steel also. Now, here's another chopper. This is up. They did this thing correct. Get it? Flawless. This cuts extremely well. You know, you could take this into a zombie apocalypse. Now, if they want to try something, they put this one on a zombie, go boom, and I bet you they'd give it a high rating. This Carnivore X with this redone handle and tang configuration. The other one had a spongy handle. That one's not as good as this one. This one got some notching on the back of the handle for texture. It's got a finger groove there and an X on the handle. I like that. Give it some uniqueness. Then we get down here to the another kukri. This is a sharp bludgeoning tool that you could do some camp chores with it. You could do some yard work with it. It's gonna be hard on your wrist. Yeah. This is hard on your hand. But nevertheless, it's a good knife. Good thick knife. They tapered the tang down. It's got a good upswept belly on it. Not a really good point. I like a good pointed cookery, but this, they just don't seem to come from Nepal with good points on them. Unless you get them from a certain manufacturer. But yeah, this one here, this is okay. Then we got the green, big green boy. The big green baby. With the palm swell in the handle. A lot of palm swell. You know. Once you get used to the palm swell, which it took me a little bit getting used to because I wasn't using it. Because it hadn't had an edge on it. So, you know. Every time I pick it up, all I could feel was that look at that dull edge that it had on it and all that palm swelling handle. But actually, once you get a little used to it, the palm swelling so bad. And then I also have the one with the bone handle. The Gator Boy. So, yeah, but this big green one has a very similar blade to it, to the Gator Boy. And that's a stainless steel blade. the big green boy, the Carnival X is stainless steel, and this one's carbon steel. That's why it's got the patina on it. This has a patina on it. It's carbon steel. That was how I tested to make sure it was carbon steel, and not just a so-so. They claim to be carbon steel. It's real. It's the real deal. It's carbon. It took a mustard patina, very well, nicely designed on there. Little leopard spots on one side, and rough and ready R's on the other side. And then I put an edge on it with the Edge Pro. What did the Edge Pro? Goodness gracious, with the Workshop. Yeah, she had a nice tip on it too. She'll stick a pig real good. Chopper. Okay. Only problem they did with this is they put good wood on it, but they just didn't put the good finish on it because it's kind of, you can feel it across there. It's like a half a millimeter higher than it should be. It should be smoothed down some more, but I can live with it. Then we get back to the last knife of this video. Here they go all lined up again. From the Timber Rattler, the Mossy Oak, the other Mossy Oak, the Cookery, the bigger Cookery, the Turtle Man, the Charade, the M-Tech, the Rough Rider, the Camillus, the Cookery from Cookery Trades, the Big Green Boy from Bud K, and the Cisco Boy. And then we get back to the Timber Rattler Boy. Now, the reason I put this one in here versus that one is because, see, this one, even though it's a big knife, it has a thin handle on it, you know, and it feels different when you buff the handle up some. When you buff the handle up some and make it a little bigger, it feels different. It feels like a totally different knife. And it seems to help you hold it better and chop better, chop different than when it just got this regular handle on it. So I like it when it's bulked up a little. But I also like it this way as well. So yeah, this is another one. This one that I recently sharpened. And showed a little video of it, how it sharpened up with a Workshop. So yeah, these will get really good and sharp. They're good knives. And even to this day, I would say, if you haven't got one, go ahead and make that purchase. You won't be upset. Now, with that being said, we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 knives there. And 13 different types. And that's a small little showing of some of my boy collection. Hope you've enjoyed it. Peace. Have a good day. Until next time, take it easy and try and stay cool.